mobile cameras for broadcast, use spectrum to enable the transmission of video images. Omega timing and scoring results, much of the information passed, use spectrum to enable the transmission of timing and scoring data. Wi-Fi networks within and around venues. It's one of these essential services that's required simply to allow the games to function.
Our dependency is total. The possible interferences of our cameras and systems and the rights holders' systems directly affect our broadcast and our content. The ability to plan and work with the committee in advance to ensure that the frequencies we require are available and then policed at games time is very, very important to us.
Radio spectrum plays a vital role in many mission-critical elements of the Olympic Games. Yet it's a finite resource. A major sporting event like the Olympic Games places an increased burden on what is already a congested radio spectrum within the host country. Early engagement with stakeholders is crucial to ensure the efficient, unbiased, and economical use of the radio frequency spectrum by all radio communication services.
I think the key thing is to start as early as you can to identify the requirements with your stakeholders. In particular, the OCOG has to engage with the relevant government organisations, probably the regulator, to agree what that spectrum plan is in the first place, and then agree on how it is to be implemented, how it is to be communicated, how it is to be enforced.
The ordering portal should be opened as soon as possible, and normally you give everybody a brief. Here's our spectrum plan, this is what we expect, here's the frequency bands we actually have in use within this particular country, because you need a lot of information when ordering, and the more information you can get off the people, the best you can find the place to put their equipment.
One of the key considerations is a clear understanding between licensed spectrum and license exempt spectrum, and the approaches to take with each.
Licensed spectrum is where the government actually gives you a license to use that spectrum and it's protected. So you would get the government come in and monitor it, and if there was anybody else using it who's not licensed, they'd be told to stop using it.
One of the most important things in this day and age as we go forward is the use of Wi-Fi, so license exempt spectrum, which is actually hard to control. Lots of people have mobile phones, which of course give the ability to create wireless Wi-Fi hotspots. My suggestion would be to make sure that any Wi-Fi device that's brought into a venue has been approved, has been tested, has been tagged, and has been given an allocated channel that it can work on without interfering with other devices in the venues.
Radio spectrum is used extensively for timing and scoring in the timing devices and transponders on athletes to capture key data. So both the timing and scoring partner and international federations need to be engaged at an early stage to understand their spectrum needs and apply early for specific license frequencies.
The challenge with spectrum, it's a very busy space and everybody wants a piece of this cake that has only so many pieces. So in order to ensure that our services are delivered effectively, we provide them very early with that early engagement so that the authorities can actually register those frequencies.
But the biggest user of spectrum is broadcast. OBS requires a specific band of spectrum which needs to be allocated in the venues and for wireless cameras in more remote places.
These frequencies are the ones that are allowing us to have very engaging pictures very close to the actual action, where it is impossible for us to have wired or cabled solutions, and the only available technologies are through RF spectrum.
Once the games go live, testing and tagging is crucial in keeping interference under control in the venues.
What we're trying to do is ask users of wireless devices to bring those devices to a location where they can be tested for their frequency operability and their power levels to make sure they conform with the standards for those frequencies. And if they do conform, then they're given a tag which allows them to be brought into the venue. It's quite important for an OCOG technology team to work with the OCOG security team to make sure that only approved devices are brought into venues.
It's equally important for each venue to have spectrum monitoring in place, operated by the host country regulator.
So here and there, we are experiencing one or the other interferences that happen for different reasons, but we have their support on monitoring those, and then we go there, we triangulate, find the source, and we shut it down immediately. They have like a police force authority in order to refrain any type of misuse of frequency in the spectrum.
You don't need the spectrum in many cases for all of the games. So it could be that one user uses it for a certain period of time and another user for another period of time. Can you negotiate with some of the authorities or the users in the city to free up some spectrum during games time? So these are the questions you have to ask when you're going through the development of the plan.
We have to work very closely with the committee to ensure that, first of all, they can find the available spectrum, and then they can deliver that spectrum in cooperation with governmental agencies and with telecom providers to ensure that we are able to operate safely within the bands they can provide. The earlier that we can engage with the OCOG, the better. We have multi-games experience of how this process needs to be planned. We want to advise on many different issues we've had in the past.
The advice that I can pass on to future organizers is set up a good governance model with the local authorities and the key stakeholders. Have a clear plan as how you're going to move forward. And very early in the project, establish where you're going to have challenges. And then be very open with the authorities, with your stakeholders, as how you plan to move forward to arrive at solutions that will enable them to have the spectrum that they need to deliver the games.